Hi friends, I am Saith and welcome back to my channel Saith Tech. In today's ready to do the Geek Benchmark 5 test comparison finally with the Poco F3 GT versus Realme X1 Max. Yes, I'm really excited to do this kind of comparison between these both phones because both phones they do have the Dimensity 1200. A lot of users are actually interested to know which phone is really optimized for the Dimensity 1200. That's a lot of users are actually waiting for this kind of answer. Let's start with the basic Geek Benchmark test first, and then I'll try to continue doing all the reviews on these both phones comparing together in the next couple of days. So make sure to stay tuned, friends, in case if you're having any other doubts. My playlist is created on the Poco F3 GT that will be really helpful for you in case if you want to buy any other smartphone. Try to check the playlist for each and every phones. So let me try to clear first all the background applications in both phones. So all the background applications are completely clean in both phones. Let me try to open the Geek Benchmark. So here's the Geek Benchmark application. So it should be yes. So both phones are ready with the Geek Benchmark. Let's see, friends, which phone will score how much kind of Geek Benchmark single core and the multi core. That is what I'm really interested to do. And let's start at same time. And both phones I did start at same time. So it's really interesting to see, friends, because even though the both phones I got the Dimensity 1200, and it also depends upon the UI. So how better the UI is optimized and how much performance we can get out of the processor. That matters a lot. The reason I'm saying, because I do have the IQ 7 device. This is IQ 7 with the Snapdragon 870, with MI11X also with the Snapdragon 870. But this phone is performance monster. Why? Because of the UI optimization and the RAM management. That is the reason why this phone performs really best in terms of the gaming. So that is what a lot of users are actually interested to see. So same thing is gonna apply here or not. Right now in the another benchmark test results, I did see the slightly lower score in the Poco F3 GT, to be frank, but let's see how well this Geek Benchmark 5 score will come here. So single core and the multi core. So this will definitely decide what is happening. And here the percentage also slightly faster on the Realme X1 Max. You can see, friends, clearly. Absolutely. During this time of testing, I'm not trying to use any RAM, any external RAM capabilities in this phone. So both phones are 8GB RAM variants. I forgot to mention that first. So both phones are completely 8GB RAM variants only. So this is going to be really interesting test, friends, between both devices to see. So which phone performs how much. And right now the score started to come close to Realme X1 Max. Single core versus multi core. So meanwhile, what you need to do is that stay tuned. Every day, every hour, I'll try to upload so many videos. So in case if you're planning to buy this phone, don't forget to check the playlist. I'm trying to stress again and again, I'm creating the playlist not for me to watch, only for you to watch. Only you people should watch the playlist and decide whether to buy the phone or not. Try to check the playlist every day. And the first phone to finish is the Realme X1 Max. And one more quick note, I'm not sure, few of the users, they did mention that their unit, they was able to get the single core 969, but still the multi-core they are getting about 3000 as well sometimes. So that is what the few of the users, they did mention who are using the Realme X1 Max. So my unit is 8GB RAM variant only. And you can see the scores between both phones in terms of the single core. I think in the single core, the Realme X1 Max is slightly the best, 961, not bad. And in the multi-core, 2844 and 2732 in the multi-core. You can see the difference between both phones. I'll try to show you the history. Let me try to show you the history. What is the Realme X1 Max? So you can see the history, how the Realme X1 Max is behaving in terms of the scores. As you can see, it's a single core and the multi-core. You can see I did reach the 1x3000 as well. So only I reached 3000 when you try to use all the different extra benefits like high performance mode, game space, clearing all the background applications and everything. Only then I was able to get the 3000 in this Realme X1 Max. So this is just the day one, friends, on the Poco F3 GT. So we are not going to judge this phone on the day one of usage. So make sure to stay tuned for the next couple of days, maybe for the next 2 to 3 days. And then I'll be able to come up with some kind of conclusion on this Poco F3 GT. So thank you for watching this video, friends, and see you in the next video. Until then, stay tuned for more updates. Meanwhile, don't forget to check the playlist, and the playlist will give you the clear idea what is going on with the phones. Absolutely. See you in the next video, friends. Until then, bye.